We talked about electron energy levels. Now it's time to get more specific.
In the last video, we only modeled an atom having one electron. For atoms having multiple electrons, we need to talk about orbitals, areas where we expect those electrons to be positioned. These orbitals come in a few shapes and sizes, but for now we have these four: S, P, D, and F.
Initially, metals reflect white because, as I said in the last video, there are so many ways an electron can jump from energy level to energy level.
All these combinations have their corresponding wavelengths. In other words, colors. And we know when we combine light of different wavelengths, they look more and more white.
Now let's look at metals with heavier nuclei.
An electron would need to move faster to deal with the intense attraction to the positive nuclei. Heavy atoms mean they have more protons in their nucleus, and hence a greater positive charge.
Here's where Einstein's special relativity comes in. The faster anything moves, the heavier it gets.
As our electrons move faster and hence have more kinetic energy, they feel heavier. And you can watch about why that is in my 3-minute video about that.
But how scientists got there wasn't a smooth ride.
Einstein's special relativity was published in 1905. In 1929, Dirac said in small-scale systems such as atoms and molecules, we don't need to care about relativity. It doesn't matter how fast these tiny things are moving.
Not until 1935. English physicist and badass Bertha Swirles published The Relativistic Self-Consistent Field.
AKA, you are all wrong. We need to talk about special relativity in the atomic scale.
And they did. Relativity is why gold is yellowish.
Remember those faster and heavier electrons in heavy metals? Well, the position of gold's outermost electron is in a place called the S orbital, and the next available position is one called the D orbital. So when a photon hits a gold atom, this outermost electron gets excited from the S to the D orbital.
What's cool is this.
This S orbital actually gets smaller than its original size. Heavier electrons mean a stronger gravitational attraction to the nucleus too. And so more often than not, this electron is positioned closer to the nucleus than we'd expect. As for the D orbital, since our S orbital is closer, it's harder for an electron in the D position to come near the positive nucleus, because the electron in S is hogging all the attention. This is called shielding, and what happens is that the D orbital ends up expanding. Overall, the distance between an electron in the S and in the D orbital got larger. To cover a larger distance with the same speed, since the speed of light is constant, we'd need light with a smaller frequency. This means we would expect blue light to be absorbed more. Everything else still gets reflected, and that's why gold has that tint of yellow.
I hope you enjoyed this video. Check out my other videos, also made with tons of love. And as usual, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.